Now that DJI has announced the NAZA version 2, they haven't forgotten about owners of the original NAZA. You can install the new firmware on your old flight controller. First, plug in your NAZA 1, power up the copter, and start your existing NAZA assistant software. The old assistant software will check for updates and show that you are fully up to date. To install the latest firmware, you have to install new assistant software. Before we do that, be sure to make note of your gain settings, as you may have to re-input them later. To get the new NAZA assistant software, go to www.dji-innovations.com. Navigate to the main support section. Find the NAZA-M version 2 product support section. Once there, select Downloads. Then download the newest NAZA-M assistant software. While you're here, notice that you can't download the firmware installer. The new assistant software will do that for you. Now, when you go to the DJI folder in your Programs folder, you will find the old NAZA Assistant and the new NAZA Assistant. Start up the new Assistant. The first dialog box will ask you to log in with the credentials you gave when you set up your NAZA the first time. You'll see an announcement screen with the cool new features you are about to enjoy. The next screen will be a notification that there is a firmware update. Click Update, and you will be warned that the propellers should be removed before installing the update. Take this very seriously. There's a possibility that the motors could spin up during the firmware upgrade. Remove those props. Once that is done, click Yes, and the firmware updates will start. When finished, you will be asked to power cycle the NAZA. Just unplug the battery and plug it back in. When it reboots, it's time to recalibrate the inertial management unit. Click OK, then click the Advanced Cali button. Make sure that the NAZA is level and you do not move it during the recalibration. This can take up to 10 minutes. Just leave it alone. Now click around and familiarize yourself with where everything is in the new assistant software. The upgrade seems to have retained all of the previous settings. DJI's documentation says to reset to the factory defaults and retune the NAZA flight settings. I think I'm going to leave things as they are for now and see how it flies. My RC settings seem slightly out of whack, but a quick calibration fixes that. That's it. You've installed the NAZA version 2 firmware on your version 1 hardware. Of course, the weather isn't cooperating for an outdoor test today, but a quick test in the living room is spot on. NAZA version 2 even deals well with the swirling prop wash created when flying a large copter in an enclosed area.